listening to Capital XTRA Breakfast. Robert Bruce and Shayna Marie, and we are super excited this morning.
We are joined by the baby girl taking over right now.
Reigning from Johannesburg, South Africa, she's a singer, songwriter and dancer.
She supported Chris Brown on his UK and European tour earlier this year.
Currently taking over TikTok, taking over the world with her newest track, Water.
Everybody, it's Tyla!
Hello.
Hello, how you doing? How you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. First of all, congratulations on everything. How does it feel like just everything that's going on around you right now?
Oh, guys, it's crazy. Like, I can't believe this is all happening. It's crazy.
Yeah, you're actually number one on the UK Afrobeats chart at the moment as well. Had you been coming to the UK before this song? Like, was it your first time around this time around, or had you been before?
I came here the first time during the Mobile Awards.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I was here when it was very cold. So I'm happy it's a bit warm now. But yeah, I've been here.
Nice.
This is the very fluke English weather, though. It's usually quite cold around this time normally. So I feel like you've been blessed to come at a good time. We saw you hanging out with Flo a little while ago in the club, having a good time. Would something possibly be coming in the works with you guys?
Well, we haven't gotten in yet, but definitely we've spoken about it. Because I love the girls. Flo, oh, love them.
You guys look like you had such a good time when you was out, right?
We did, but guys, we went to the box, and I had no idea that was what the box was. So it was a bit hectic, but we had fun. Yeah. So fun.
Sick. So that's Flo. Are there any other British artists that you love? Like, who are the people on your playlist from the UK?
Love Pink Pantherist, Dave, Central C, Ray. Oh, love. Yeah, those are a few.
Mm-hmm. Ray would be a really good one. Yeah. That would be amazing, yeah. She is, yeah, gorgeous. How was touring with Chris Brown? Up and down the UK, up and down Europe. Did he give you any advice or any tips or any like conversations on how to get, you know, you're almost there, world domination?
Oh, he taught me a lot. Like, people don't know, but I haven't performed a lot before the tour. So that was like my first actual performance. It was literally on the O2 stage, wow, opening for the show. So it was a crazy time for me, but I learned so much from the tour, like so much. It was amazing.
What words of wisdom did he give you? Like, is there anything that he said that really stuck with you? Like the first thing that pops to mind?
He just kept saying that I must do what I feel is right. Like I must trust my gut and push for that, you know? And that stuck with me because, hey, yeah.
What does that mean?
Yo, guys, it's very difficult to explain my... It just means... Hey, I don't even know, guys. It's just a thing in South Africa. We make a lot of sounds.
Okay, yeah, okay, yeah, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, we make a lot of sounds.
So do the sounds represent how you feel?
Yes. Yes. Like, that should tell you what I feel. Okay. Like, hey! Yeah.
We got it.
Talk to us about your career though. Like, when did you start making music? Who was you looking up to?
So, I mean, I've always loved music and knew I was going to become a singer. Like, since I was small, I was that child that was making shows for everyone, performing in primary school, high school, everywhere I could. Like, I always told my parents that I was going to get into music and they never really took me serious. Mm-hmm. But like my last year of school, I was like, okay, guys, I'm done now. So I got them to let me take a gap year. They let me, and then getting late, started taking off, and I got signed to Epic Records. Mm. But yeah, before then, like, oh, I was grinding. Yeah. Oh, the struggle was real. Like, I was making videos, posting on Instagram, TikTok, Musical.ly at the time, and DMing every celebrity that anyone that had a blue tick, I was DMing. Yeah. And never got a response. But I mean, look where I am today. It's moving. So, yeah.
Have you had any of them DMs like come round back to you?
Guys, this happened the other day.
Really?
And it was so embarrassing. Oh my gosh, so embarrassing. So Normani DM'd me.
Wow.
The queen. Mm. She was like, oh, I love Water. I'm excited. I scroll up and I see this video I sent her. Oh my gosh. I hope she did not see it, but I was singing her Wild Side song and I was trying to sound American. Okay. So yeah, it was very embarrassing, but... Yeah.
Full circle.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Trust me, we've got to start somewhere.
Yeah.
You built up a big fan base now, though. What do they call your fans?
Tigers.
The Tigers. How comes?
How? Tyla Tigers. People say I give off that tigress energy, so it only makes sense.
Yeah.
Nice one.
I'm a tiger too. We got to talk about the water challenge. I tried it, kind of.
Shayna tried it on stage. Yeah. We had a show. She tried it on stage.
It was by you. I saw you on stage and I was like, I'm going to be on stage and I'm going to do it. And then I chickened out. I got cold feet and then I put the water down. How did this become a thing? How did you come up with the dance? How did you come up with the challenge?
So I have this choreographer that I work with in South Africa, and we were making the show that I was traveling Europe with this year. And the dance was actually meant for a different song. Mm. Because, I mean, the dance style is Bacardi. It's a style in South Africa. And it's usually not done with this type of music. So it didn't really fit. But I was like, nah, like, it looks good on water. Like, it looks so good. We have to do it on water. And then we ended up rehearsing it and... Why, I was just like, let me pour water on my back. Like, let's take it to the max. Like, mm-hmm. we need this video to travel. Mm-hmm. So I was trying to pull out every trick I had in the book. And yeah, I just did it on stage. I poured the water on my back and that video went crazy. Like, I remember traveling back from the show from Rwanda and I just posted it before the flight. And when I landed, it was like 4 million views or something. Mm. And I was like, nah, this is it. Like, it's moving. So that's
moved, yeah.
Yeah, it's moving.
Yeah,
everything's moving.
Yeah. Still moving. Still moving, still growing. It's wicked. We heard you are dropping a debut album. We are super, super excited. What can we expect from a debut Tyla album?
The sound is very new, very fresh. It's African, but with its pop and R&B twist. It's always been my sound and my vibe, but I feel like this album is the mature version of it, you know, like my true Afro pop, Afro piano, pop piano, like mm-hmm. mixture all in one body of work. And yeah, like I'm just excited for people to hear what I've been having in the vaults. Like I've been recording for this album like over 2 years now, I think. And yeah, there's just a whole bunch of bangers. So yeah, get ready.
Get ready. What sort of sound will represent this album?
Pop piano, pop piano,
yeah.
Pop piano. Like, I'm a piano as a genre in South Africa. I know you guys are feeling
it.
Yeah,
we love it over here.
Yeah, I know. And I just, it's now a version that sits more with me because I grew up listening to a lot of pop and R&B. So I just love the sound of it mixed with my African sound.
Nice.
And we want to get to know you a little bit better. We're going to put a timer on the clock, 60 seconds, and ask you as many questions as you possibly can in that time. You just got to answer quick fire style, first thing that comes into your head.
Yeah, okay.
Okay? All right. What's been the highlight of your career so far?
Billboard Hot 100.
Your favorite South African dish?
Pap and chutney.
What did your last text message say?
I'm in the lobby.
What are three differences between parties in the UK and parties in South Africa?
In South Africa, people are on tables hanging from ceilings. Like, it's wild. I haven't really partied much in the box. Hey, the box. We don't have things like the box in South Africa. That's one thing. You know? Yeah, like, I feel like in London, I see more people, like, chill, like, be cool.
Mm.
In South Africa, no one's cool. Like, everyone's just everywhere.
How would your friends describe you in three words?
Funny, bubbly, and ambitious.
When I say scissor, what lyric comes to mind?
I can when I'm with you. Yo, that song, guys.
Mm. All right, final question. What are you currently grateful for?
Just being able to put South Africa on the map. Like, yo, we don't have a lot of South Africans that come this far. So I'm just so blessed to be able to be one, you know?
And that was 60 seconds with Tyla. Yes. Yeah,
well done,
nice.
Well done, well done. You answer the questions quick. Yeah, people are
normally
like,
yeah.
Yeah.
All right then, Tyla, we want to show you this, right? Obviously, the water challenge is going crazy all mm-hmm. across the world. So we've got a few and we would like you to rate them for us.
What do you think?
How? There's Uncle Waffles, there's Tyla. This video is perfect. Perfect.
All right, next one.
Oh, that girl is shaking it. The girl killed it. The guy can loosen up a bit.
Loosen up a bit.
Yeah. It's cute, but yeah, the bum was not moving.
Yeah. What advice would you give to make the bum move, you know?
Use your back, like move your bum. Like, she was jumping and it's cute, mm-hmm. but if you want it to shake, you need to loosen up the back.
That's kind of how I looked when I tried.
I'll teach you after this.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. All right, next one.
Love. Nah, she killed it. Yeah, and you can see there was takes because our bum's already wet. That's the evidence.
That's the evidence. You've been practicing.
Yeah.
So the advice is loosen up your back.
Yeah, loosen up mm-hmm. your back, your bum. Like, just let it loose and then it'll bounce more. Like, you don't even need a big bum. Like, I'm very much petite, but it shakes.
It shakes. Yeah. All right, now, Tyla, we want to test your knowledge of H2O. Good old water. Now, in the UK, we ride for our favourite water brands. Mm-hmm. Like, it's like a thing that we love them, we ride with them, we drink only that and that brand only. So we want to test a few of them for you and get you to rate them out of 10. What tastes the best and what kind of person would drink what kind of water?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay, so here is the first glass of water for Tyla. Mm-hmm. Nice.
Nice.
It's okay.
Out of 10?
What sort of person do you think would drink this sort of water?
Just like a boy that just wanted water quick from any tap, any tap they found, like they just needed water. Like,
this is Highland Spring.
Highland Spring.
I'm sorry, Highland Spring.
But I feel like this is like a quick and easy, like you need water, yeah, you want water.
Yeah, this is like, you're very thirsty.
Yeah. Yeah. So I think you were right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hold the bottle. Let her hold the Highland Spring. So this is Highland Spring. Okay. It's actually my favourite.
This is
yes.
Perfect. Perfect.
Sorted.
Yeah.
Okay, next one.
Mm-mm.
No. Mm-mm. Not a fan. Out of 10.
Four.
You sound disappointed.
There's like a taste. What's it supposed to taste like? Nothing.
Fair enough. One was Fiji water.
Ooh, and I know this Fiji water. Okay.
Yeah, 4 out of 10 for Fiji water.
This is like a bougie type of water, though.
Is it?
Yeah, man.
Oh.
Not for Tyla.
All right, then. Water number 3.
I don't like sparkling water. So, hey. Bottom of the list.
Bottom of the list. What out of 10?
3 out of 10. Okay, sparkling though. Sparkling.
Yes.
I like this brand, but sparkling, I really don't like sparkling water.
No, okay, fam.
Fair.
Yeah.
You love it, you hate it.
I don't like sparkling either. It's not like the greatest. Yeah. Okay. We got another one for you.
That's the best one.
That's the best one.
Straight away.
Best one.
Why?
Out of 10.
Like 7.
And why?
Because there's less of a taste. And
feels clear.
It just feels like water. Like
flowing like the water fountain. Yeah,
yeah, like water dripping off the spring mountain.
Come on, yeah.
There you go.
And the bottle's even cute.
Yeah. It's a Voss bottle of water. That was your fave?
Yeah, that's my favorite.
That makes sense.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to drink good water from Tyla herself, you got to be drinking Vossy. It's got to be. You got to be drinking Vossy.
Tyla, what's the rest of the year looking like for you? I know we're coming to the end of it. What's the rest of the year looking like for you?
Performances, debut album though, like that is the highlight of this year right now.
When is that coming? Do we have a date for it? Do we have...
November,
okay. Real soon.
Real soon. And what's your dream like? Where do you want to take this from here? Because obviously you've done so well so far, so quick. Where do you see this panning out over the next 10, 20 years?
I really see myself being the biggest pop star of my time. And I'm just really wanting it to be... a moment for Africa, you know, because we need that representation for people back home. Because, I mean, when I was small, I didn't really have examples that were where I wanted to be. So I just would love to be that example, you know.
We're looking forward to watching you go and do it. Thank you very much for coming to the studio this morning. Everybody, one more time. It's Tyla, everybody! Yeah! Woo-hoo!